Time for the Taste of Sunrise with Christina Xenos of Sweet Greek Personal Chef Services.
And she has a great dish planned for us. It's Spanakopita. Christina, this is a Greek classic, right?
This is a Greek classic. This is my favorite dish. This is my signature dish, and yes. I've won contests, and I've been eating it all my life. So
Good.
I can't
Fantastic.
Wait to show you guys how to make
I'm
it.
I'm looking forward to it because I don't know, and I've always wanted to know how to use the phyllo dough. So you're going to show us
you
how
need
to
a
make it work.
Finesse, but okay. we can do
so
it.
So let's go to work. What do we have?
All
what
right,
are the
cool.
ingredients?
So the ingredients are: you start with 2 pounds of spinach, and you can see when you cook 2 pounds of spinach down. It gets
nothing.
Really small. Yeah. And then we have a hard salty cheese. Today it's Romano, and the Greeks normally use a cheese called kefalotiri, which is it translates to head cheese, but it's a hard salty cheese.
Okay.
And that's feta cheese, which is common and it's like the staple backbone
cheese.
Of all yeah. Greek food.
Yes.
And then we have some sauteed scallions. So maybe 3 or 4 bunches of those.
Nice.
So how do we put this together?
So we're going to start just putting everything in the bowl.
Okay.
So we can, let's start with the feta.
The
and
both
so we can
packages?
Put both packages
oh,
in there.
That's
I know,
so
it's so exciting,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
And
I
so
love feta.
The feta adds a saltiness and a brininess mm-hmm. to the pie. And then we'll add the cream cheese. And the cream cheese makes everything creamy. And it also helps bind everything
bind it,
together.
Right, bind the ingredients.
And then the herbs that we're using in this pie are dill, fresh dill, and fresh mint.
Nice.
Wow.
Smells
so good, right?
yeah.
I know. We're
and
growing
dill,
this.
Dill, I love dill too.
It's
right.
so it's good. Great. We're growing this yeah. in our garden.
Oh, nice.
Oh,
even better.
So
all of it?
All of it.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
All
right.
Hey,
oh, it's
and then
healthy too.
It's super healthy, and depending on what you have on hand, you can use parsley, you can use, you know, nice. Just a mix of things that you have. Yeah. It's really loose, and any Greek you talk to will probably have a different way
really?
Of doing
oh,
it.
Version.
Yeah.
On the scallions, do you use
oh,
butter for those
to
saute those, or what?
How I
do
use olive oil
olive
for those.
Christina,
yeah,
ready
yeah
for
you
these
can,
too?
We can put
and
those
do you use
in.
An extra virgin olive oil?
I do, okay. yeah. My friend actually has olive trees up in the San Ynez Valley.
Oh, my God.
And
oh,
I wonderful. Always use her products because
oh,
they're
fantastic.
The best.
All right, what's next?
All right, so we're going to throw in the eggs, and there's just 2 eggs, and these will bind everything together.
Right.
And then we'll just, you know, the saltiness of this feta will, you know, do wonders, but we'll just add a pinch of kosher salt. Maybe
kosher. Why do you use kosher versus, say, a sea salt?
It's not iodized, and it just, the flavor, I think,
Great.
Is much better.
Okay.
I'll let you do it because I'll
okay.
mess it up.
And I'm just going to add just a couple pinches of pepper just to.
And you use Great. A cracked black pepper,
I
correct?
Do.
Wow.
And then, so my, what I usually do with my spanakopita, because the last thing you want is a soggy pie.
Yeah.
So I use farina, which is essentially cream of wheat.
Ah.
And I yeah. just put, you know, maybe a tablespoon in so it absorbs any excess moisture that might
okay.
be in there and might, you know, make well, your.
You're the award winner, so let's do it
soggy.
Your way.
Wow. All right. So are you ready to mix?
All right,
sure.
so yeah.
Someone want to get their hands
that.
Dirty?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Oh,
right.
you're put, oh, yeah.
Oh, we're doing hands dirty.
Wait,
my hands
dirty. I can get
yeah,
my hands
do,
dirty.
I can do it.
Okay,
yeah,
go
sleeves.
Right
okay.
ahead.
You can
yeah.
use just
yes.
one if you right. just want
to. I like the eating part. Okay.
you're ready to
yeah,
eat.
The eating part is good. So while Mary's mixing that, tell us, yeah. how do people, do you go into homes, you prepare weekly dishes for folks?
Yeah.
Tell us about
so
that.
So I'm a personal chef, and I work with families and people, couples, friends, everyone, and so for my family service, I'll go in and cook, you know, all their meals for the week or whatever,
oh,
however many meals they
yeah,
want.
Yeah, I have clients that need that on occasion,
I think,
too.
You know, everyone's
yeah.
so busy right
yeah.
now that I think, you know, and everyone wants to eat healthy and they want to eat what mm-hmm. they want to eat, that, you know, it's a service that, you know, is really, you know, beneficial for
And you
so
can
many
adjust
people.
Recipes for different dietary
oh,
preferences,
absolutely.
Is that right?
I work a lot with clients who are vegan and vegetarian, maybe want to do a paleo or a low-carb diet, and that's really my specialty.
So will these all be variations off Greek dishes?
No,
or
it's whatever the client wants.
Right, so right.
I love exploring new dishes
nice.
And incorporating that inspiration into what I cook for people.
And you're based in Hollywood, but you'll go anywhere
I'll
within
go.
A good radius,
Yeah, I've
right?
gone to Santa Clarita, I've gone to Claremont and Right. You know, I'm happy. I love working with people.
Oh, Christina, will I put more on the?
No, we're gonna use spoons for.
Oh, okay. This is the messy part. Here.
Yeah, you're having fun, right?
Thank you.
Oh, it smells good too. You can smell it.
Oh my gosh, I love it. It's so good. You know, you can put this in a ravioli if you want. You can get really crazy with it.
Or you could just eat it.
Or you could just eat it.
You know, I like the eating part. So what? Phyllo dough.
So this is phyllo dough, and what I've done is usually you can buy a roll of phyllo dough in your supermarket, and I've cut it into thirds.
Right.
And so we're going to start with, we're going to take each individual sheet.
Paper thin,
yeah.
So clunky hands like mine, beware.
Oh, you know. So my trick to phyllo, the one thing you want to do is keep it from drying out. So what I have here is a moist towel, and I just keep it covered so it doesn't, because once it dries out, it gets really cracky, and then everyone, you know, that's why people don't like working with it.
Okay.
So then I have a natural bristle pastry brush, and I'm just going to dip it in the olive oil. You can also use melted butter, but today we're going to use olive oil, and then you completely cover the piece.
So the olive oil would be flavor, and butter would be a little different flavor, but also calories, be more calories.
A lot of times, you know, people who are watching their cholesterol, or, you know, if I wanted to make a vegan version of this, olive oil would definitely be what I would use.
All right, so the magic of TV, you would assemble this, putting...
Yeah, so we would do that.
So right. I would do 3 or 4 sheets of phyllo.
Right.
And then we would put...
Keep layering?
Yeah. I mean, do we have time to keep layering?
We're just going to be finishing up, and we got to get to the eating part.
Okay. Let's eat first, and then we'll make more later.
How long does it go into the oven?
So once you've assembled all your triangles, it goes into the oven for about a half an hour. So what you would do prior to putting it in the oven is make an egg wash. We have one here, and you would brush it on the top so it gets the nice brown.
And that you get the golden brown color,
exactly.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
How do people get a hold of you?
Yep.
So my website is mysweetgreek.com, and that's the best place to find me. Not only do I work with clients in their homes, I do pop-up dinners with organizations like Feastly and Eat With, and they're super fun and social. So
fantastic!
It's really, really fun.
Yes. Well, I'm going to be
eating.
Incredible. Well, listen, that's it for the show this week, and we want to thanks to Alexis Walker, John Frickenberg, Dr. Jeff Barkey, Jordan Utley, and Christina at Xenos.
I am so glad you were here, and while my mouth is full, thanks also to our amazing Crown City News team and the CCN Sunrise crew. We also want to thank our sponsors, including Foothill Transit, EH Financial, San Gabriel Valley, ROP, Color Dots, The Smile Agency. You've all made the show possible for us. And we also want to thank our NGOT Global Consultants, our accountants, for keeping us our numbers straight. And we also want to thank San Gabriel Valley Economic Partnership.
Yes, and don't forget to join us on Crown City News, crowncitynews.com, the Crown City News YouTube, and also Crown City News CCN.com. And join us on KVMD on Saturdays at 6 a.m., Sundays at 5 a.m. We'll see you next time.
Take care.